This project for the Adelaide started as an artificial reef project. There's always benthic marine life under the sand, and we wanted to draw in marine life to a place where there wasn't any. One of our diving friends told us that he'd heard that the HMAS Brisbane was going to be decommissioned, and what a great idea it would be if we could get it and have it scuttled as an artificial reef. So we formed a committee of 7 people. We started the Central Coast Artificial Reef Project, or CARP as we like to call it, in the year 2000. The journey to get the Adelaide took us over hurdles and exposed to things that we never thought we would be exposed to before. There were highs and there were lows, but the biggest high was when we eventually scuttled the ship over 10 years later. In order to get a ship, the first thing we had to do was write to every member of parliament on both sides of government, at all levels of government, trying to explain to them the benefits that this would have on both our local economy and on the marine biodiversity that this artificial reef would bring. Our mission was to get, hopefully, an Australian ship to scuttle, but after a year or two we became pretty desperate and we started to look at any ship that was available. We contacted the American Navy because we'd heard that they had a ship that they were going to decommission. The answer was no. We had an English naval ship that actually ran aground on one of the islands off Australia. I wrote to the British Admiralty asking to have that ship, and I got a one sentence reply that basically said no. And we even went for a ship that was impounded because of drugs, the Pong Su, and that was politically sensitive, so the Australian government said no, and that was scuttled in deep water.
We carry on regardless, and we even tried to get some aeroplane, even buses, to sink something on the Central Coast as an artificial reef project.
When we heard that there were 2 ships going to be decommissioned, we were feeling a bit despondent because we'd lost so many in the past. And I got a phone call from the then local federal member, Jim Lloyd, from his secretary, and he said, "I can tell you that there are 2 ships going to be decommissioned. The first one that will be allowed to be scuttled is the Canberra, but you're not going to get it." And I went, "Oh," and he said, "but the second one is the Adelaide, and I can guarantee you that it is going to be gifted to New South Wales for the Central Coast." And I was delighted because my son served on the Adelaide, so it was very near and dear to me, so it was even better.
We had to find the site to sink it. We had to find the right depth off the sand, so the ship would settle down nicely.
So it had to be 2 meters deep at minimum to do that, and with no marine life around other than the occasional passing by. Because we were just a group of 7 people, we often had to do things in the best manner that we could. We didn't have side scan sonars to find the right spot. We didn't know how deep the sand was. So one of our group, Carlo Filippetti, who's just a wonder of a man and has had so much experience in diving and the marine life, decided that he was going to make spears that were going to be propelled down into the sand using compressed air.
It's about 2 meter high, around 3/4 inch thick hollow tube, and we connected some nipples to connect the hoses from a regulator to the cylinder. And the divers only had to do hold the handle and point that directly on the sand, turn the head on, and the air would do the job, and it would sink until they find a solid a rock or anything to find the right depth of the sand, which we did. And we worked for weeks on end. That includes many divers until we find the right area.
When we finally got approval to have the wreck, the Department of Lands had to survey the area to see if that's exactly what was going to be the right site. And they put very expensive, more than side-scan sonars over there and actually confirmed what our little spears that Carlo had made, they actually confirmed that it was correct and it was the best site. Before the Adelaide was scuttled, a lot of planning went into the preparation of the ship, not only making it ready and clean to be scuttled, but to make sure that holes were strategically placed so that there was natural light penetration and a lot of it into every single compartment. So it means that there's good diver access and egress into every part of the wreck. And the holes aren't small. They're 2 metres square at least, some a lot bigger than that. So it's very good. You can always see your exit wherever you are. We were told by the marine scientists that what would happen was, as the colonies of fish on the close by reefs grew and grew, they would then look for other reefs to populate, so a spillover effect. And this was what was going to happen with the Adelaide. The spillover effect of the marine life would go and then colonise the wreck. And that's exactly what's happened. From day one, we went and dived 5 days after it had been scuttled, and there was already marine life on it. We were absolutely amazed. Since then, it's grown, and I never thought that I would see in our temperate waters hard corals growing on the Adelaide. But when you go down there, the most beautiful hard corals are on every post and every part of the mast and all the ropes that are around. And they're amazing colours, bright blues, bright purples, bright pinks and oranges and whites. It is just seriously amazing the life that the ship has attracted. The Adelaide lies 1.6 kilometres off north of Ogre Beach and 1.4 kilometres off the Skillion. She is over 14 metres wide and over 139 metres in length, and she was home to over 200 sailors when she was in service. And the best thing about the Adelaide is it's just a short 5 minute boat ride from Terrigal Boat Ramp. There's a lot to see on the Adelaide. Here are just some of the highlights. When we first selected a site, we wanted it to be approximately 30 to 35 metres deep so that it was diveable to lots of different levels of diving. Here's plans of the ship. This one here is main deck or one deck. There's a deck above that, which is 01 deck. And then top deck is 02 deck. Above 02 deck, you also have the bridge over here. You can see the two masts here have been cut off at the top so that there's a 10 metre clearance between the top of the structure and the surface of the water. That's at about 20 metres, the top deck. The main deck is at about 28 to 30, depending on whereabouts you are. Then there's two deck, three deck, foredeck. So the sand sort of sits around about the foredeck area. On the top here, the main deck, you'll notice these two what look like train tracks. They're actually the helicopter haul down system, so that when a helicopter landed, they were actually pulled into the helicopter hangars by this haul down system. On this deck, you'll also find the elevator shaft, which is on all the decks, goes straight down. The big hole there, that's where the missile launcher was located. So that goes right down to the bottom, but it's not at the deepest part. Up here is what they call mushroom vents. And when you go down on the bow, you'll see the mushroom vents. They actually look like mushrooms. They're round with a top over the top. So the mushroom vents that vent from underneath. In the Australian Navy, the main passageway of any ship is named after the city that the ship gets its name from. So the Adelaide was named after the city of Adelaide in South Australia. Therefore, the main passageway of the Adelaide ship is King William Street. Tech divers can really get the benefit out of the Adelaide. The depth and the intrigue is there for them to be able to take the time to go all through the ship. They can start at the bottom, in from the sand into the engine room or the laundry room, work their way up and go into various compartments and rooms and spend quite a long time there. In the bridge, there's what a lot of people call a captain's chair, even though it's not. And on the rear bulkhead, or the rear wall of the bridge, is a scuba tank. And inside that scuba tank is the bottle of port that my son and I drank on the day it was scuttled. And if anybody wants to go and see it, it's in on that rear wall of bulkhead. You can just rub the front of it to rub away the dust, and you can see the port bottle inside.
All I can say, my achievement to have that the Adelaide sitting there as beautiful as this, to me, just I can say in two words, I have a great satisfaction in my life to have contributed with the rest of the committee and all other diver involved to have that Adelaide sitting there where it is now.
If I was to think about the Adelaide and how I would describe it for me, I find it's been a privilege to work on this project that has delivered so much to divers and the community. I am so proud to be a part of it and honoured, and even more so with the connection with my son having served on it. It's very, very important to me in so many ways.